What happened at school today?
My transmitter is busted.
Your transmitter busted. Okay, what did your Dexcom say?
It said the transmitter battery is dead.
Didn't it say transmitter failed or something?
Yeah, it said transmitter failed.
Here it says the transmitter battery's okay, but...
Yeah, so it said that we've been looking at it, and it's been saying that the transmitter battery is fine, but today at school it said transmitter failed, so we needed a new transmitter. So that's what we're going to do today. We got a new transmitter. We had some problems earlier, and they told us to get a new one, right? Wanted to get one before the genuine one? I don't know what the deal is.
Our insurance, it didn't cost us much because of our insurance.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't, because I wanted to do it before January, before it turned over. So what we're going to do, it's on your leg, right? We are going to, what do you show them what you do here?
So we'll open this up.
And there's important that you don't take it out until you actually...
Yeah, it says once you take it out, that's when it says do not remove until ready to use. I think that's probably what, like, triggers the battery to start.
Yeah.
Or something, I don't know.
Yep. So we stuck with the G4 because it helped last for a long time, a lot longer than the G5. So this lasted over a year. Has been over a year. Our first one lasted 18 months. So, now what do we do?
So now we go in here.
Take this one off.
And I don't know if you're supposed to show this or not, the actual ID. So we're not going to show it, but in the settings, you would go to transmitter ID, and you'd enter the ID that's on the back of this.
All right, it's already. I got that set already. Use both hands. You can do it. You can do it. Put a little muscle to it. Yay! So you got that on, and then you typed in the transmitter number?
Yep. And then we'll take an alcohol.
No, don't get them mixed up.
Take an alcohol and you wipe off those contacts. You do that every time.
Yep.
Let that dry, and because we just put this sensor on not too long ago, we're going to just try using the same one.
There you go, and now that's Henry started. Knows how to start sensor, and now it's the annoying 2-hour warm-up, and we'll have to just wake you up,
annoying.
Or not wake you up, but we'll have to,
test.
I'll test you. When
test you, at what time is it? It's 8 o'clock, 8 to 9, 9 to 10, so almost 10 o'clock. You'll be snoozing. What was it like at school without a Dexcom working?
It was kind of strange. But one time I felt kind of low, but actually I was okay.
Yeah, he texted us saying he thinks he feels low, and he tested and he wasn't low, which was good.
Yeah.
So you kind of rely on your Dex. You like your Dex.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if you had a choice, you'd still keep it. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Bye.
Bye. Next week, Henry, let's tell them about your Omnipod screaming experience. At school. We have a story to tell. All right. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you next week for another Type 1 Tuesday.